turns out pretty long. And there are many possibilities of puppeteer. And this is one of the techniques that we work with as a group. I have a small group in New Delhi, and we are 12 puppeteers who work together. And mostly we work with two-person puppets, which are about the same, sometimes much smaller. And it's a technique based on the Japanese technique called mudra. And we work with shadows. And most of the work that we have done with shadows is by teaching ourselves, is playing with shadows. Because I find shadows is something where you can really make discoveries if you lock yourself in a dark room for any length of time, with preferably with a machine like this or with some torches. So before we start, if you can work with a couple of introductions, just your names and what you do, or, and very important in shadow puppetry. We're going to try and just explore them. If there's no good light or bad light, it's a question of the effect that you're looking at. You get, for example, a lot of these kind of torches. They have one strong light source in the middle, and then you get these rings outside. You get, this is the most common type, new LED light. But it doesn't have a clear outer edge because it has multiple bulbs. You get the this one, yellow one. This is a bit mild, but otherwise a yellow light is very exciting in shadow. What we don't have today is a piece of fabric. This is a screen with a black backing. But imagine if you had a fabric where you could see the shadows in the back. So you have, so we're going to try and do that. The only thing to remember is that you see everything in reverse. So that's one thing. And this is the single bulb LED light. You can do a very interesting chip with this. I can show you that. So I thought what we could do for a bit is just play with these. And if you have your mobile phone lights, those are the best. And you can use this screen or a wall. And you can try three different things. One is only to use just a part of your body to create an image. For example, you know what we used to do as kids? Make dogs and cats and stuff like that. If someone can hold this, I can go small and just run for that.
Yeah, actually, I want to do this. playing with the light all the other way.
Other way around, yeah.
The image is a little more static. you, because you were not able to move the light source simply by that because it's heavy. But you can move the image a lot more. And what this box does is it enables you to have images which are really large. So the further this machine goes from the screen, the larger the image that you get. You can get in normally in an overhead projector, you can get an 18 by 20 image. So that's pretty large. And this machine is very, very interesting because here everything is almost real size, or you know, it can be enlarged to I think about 10 times its size or 5 times its size. But with this machine, you can use really small objects and they can be 30 times their size. So this is something we started using a lot because our shadow box is shrunk, and you can take a shadow box and pencil box. You can show your pencil box, which is a luxury. So what I'll do is show you first some of the abstract possibilities. Or a thin scarf, yeah. Something like a thin scarf. It's almost like print. So on this machine, you can use a lot of textures and see what they look like. If you use a net, the puppet looks like smoke. It looks like water. You can try and test all of that. But what is magical about this machine is Star Trek. can focus it and you can also unfocus it. You can do anything. Now we come to the cutouts. There are two kinds of images. For example, this is a static image. And here, what you can do is actually move the images to the light. So it's a slightly different experience. You can do close-ups, and you can do... Also works very well on a You have to stick it on this plastic. It sticks very well on the plastic. It's hardy, it's long lasting. The only reason I use this is, so the puppets that I've shown you so far are mostly positive, which means it has an outer. Okay? When you cut inside, you're playing with negatives. This one, for example, the eye, the little ridges of the skin are negative cuts. So, where you cut inside the paper and then you cut the outline of the paper.
And that eye will be better.
For that, it will be better. Because it's just that eye cuts much better. And this one has some movement.